Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at JRFromPTC. In this tutorial, we're going to talk about the Puppet Warp, which allows you to distort images by dragging points. Puppet Warp can be very useful for many distortions such as shaping hair and repositioning body parts. In this video, I'm going to show you how the Puppet Warp works and how you can take advantage of all the options available in this tool. If this is your first time at the Photoshop Training Channel, then click on that subscribe button and enable notifications to get more free Photoshop tutorials. Okay, let's get started. For this tutorial, we're going to work with two layers, a background layer and this foreground layer of a man jumping. And I've already created a mask, so I'm going to enable the mask by holding shift and clicking on it, and it removes the background. Now, I'm going to right click on the layer and select convert to smart object to put that layer into a smart object so that we can work non-destructively. If we double click on the smart object thumbnail, it opens it up in a new tab and we can readjust the mask if need be. I'm going to close this tab, and now we're going to apply the puppet warp. I'm going to go into edit, puppet warp, and by default, you should see a mesh that looks like so. I usually don't like having the mesh on, so I always disable it. You can disable it by clicking in the show mesh checkbox in the options bar. And the way this tool works is by creating pins, and those pins allow you to move the pixels around much like you would with a puppet. Let me show you what I mean by that. I'm going to tap on his wrist and create a pin. I'm going to create a pin on his shoulder and another pin on his other shoulder. And also one right here, right where his belly button should be. Now I can click on a pin and drag it to a different position. I can do the same thing with his legs. So I'm going to create a pin right on his knee, another one right about where his ankle should be, and just move that pin over to the right. And I can do the same thing with the other leg. Now, if I want this leg, his right leg, to be in front, then we need to change the pin depth. So I'm going to select the pin that controls his right leg, this one here, and I'm going to make sure that pin pushes forward. So in the options bar under pin depth, I'm going to click on this move forward icon to push that forward like so. I can continue making more adjustments. I'm going to create another pin on his neck and move that in like so, and then one more on his elbow, and I'm going to try to get that hat over onto his head, and I'm just going to make sure the arm doesn't look so distorted. So maybe something like that. You can maybe create a pin and push his head in front of the hat or behind the hat. Depends on what you want to do. In this case, I think it looks better if his head is behind the hat. And then I can tap on the check mark to accept the changes. In the layers panel, you can see the smart filter. That's before and after. If I want to make any adjustments, I can double click on the puppet warp label and all the pins reappear, and you can reposition them if need be. So maybe I can move his leg to the right even further and just reposition his body any way that you want. You can also hover over a pin, right click on it, and select delete to delete that pin. Or you can hold Alt, Option on the Mac, and click to delete the pin. This time I'm going to hit Enter, that's return on the Mac, to commit the changes. Another thing that we can do is select a pin, for example, like this pin here on the elbow, go into the rotate input box, and if I use the up arrow, notice how it rotates the mesh. So you can use this command to rotate the mesh if you need to. If you hold shift and tap on the up and down arrows, you move in greater values. So I'm going to click on this knee here and then rotate it so you can see how it rotates. So this is a great technique to fine-tune your meshes. You could also go into the Rotate drop-down menu and select Fix and hold Alt, hover near the pin, and you'll get this Rotate UI element. You can click and drag to rotate it like so. So those are two methods in which you can rotate pins while using the Puppet Warp. Also, while inside the Puppet Warp command, you can press Control A, that's Command A on the Mac, to select all pins. Control D, Command D to deselect all pins, or you can click on a single pin and then hold shift and click on a different pin to add it to that selection. And let's quickly talk about mode, density, and expansion. Mode determines the elasticity of the mesh. Distort will give you a really stretchy mesh, while rigid will give you the opposite result. So I'm going to click on distort and notice how that stretches. I'm going to go back into rigid. And obviously it's more rigid. And we're going to go back into normal. Density specifies the spacing of the mesh. So let me enable the mesh. And by default, we're in normal. Fewer points creates fewer points in a mesh. And more points will obviously create more points in a mesh. Having more points in a mesh will give you more precise control. However, it increases processing times. Also, if Photoshop ever says that you need to increase the number of available points, then increase the density to more points. Expansion expands or contracts the outer edges of the mesh. At this moment, we have a 2-pixel expansion. We can increase it, and let me disable the mesh so that you can see the change, or we could, of course, go into the negative values. To cancel the changes you made to the puppet warp, you can simply hit the escape key on the keyboard, and that will cancel all the changes that you made. And obviously, when you're working on your image, you want to take a little more time to make sure that things don't look so distorted. I could probably do a little more work on the back leg and maybe the arm that's holding the hat. But for this tutorial, this is going to be good enough. And just as an added bonus for this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a shadow. He's up in the air. There's light coming through. So let's quickly create a shadow that is going to be cast onto the ground. So I'm going to double click to the side of the layer to bring up the layer style window. I'm going to select drop shadow. And I'm going to click on reset to default, just so that we're all looking at the same thing. I'm going to click and drag to pull the shadow out. I'm going to bring the opacity to 100%. Shadows in the real world are not black. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up the color picker and select the darkest color that I see here, which is this one here, and press OK. And I'm going to press OK one more time. Then I'm going to right click on the FX icon and select create layer. This is going to create a layer out of the layer styles. I'm going to press OK. And notice now that we have a layer out of that layer style. Then I can move the shadow over to the right. Press Control T, Command T on the Mac to transform. Right click and select distort. And we're going to distort this shadow just to try to make it fit here in our scene. So maybe something like this. Then we can go into Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. And we can blur that shadow. About 8 pixels should work. And press OK. And the reason the shadows is blurry is because I'm looking at the other shadows in the scene and they're also pretty blurry. And I'm just going to bring down the opacity about there. And that's my final image. Have you used the Puppet Warp tool before? Do you think it will help you in your projects? Leave a comment down below. If you create an image using this tutorial or any other of my tutorials, share it on Instagram with the hashtag PTCVids. And don't forget to click on that like button and share this video with a friend. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.